Hello everyone, this is Chensey and welcome to my first devlog of the Princess of Seas, Land Decoration Generation. In this video, I will show you how I generate plants and cities in the world. If you are the first time watching my video, please consider subscribing. There will be more devlogs of my game every month. By far, we have generated the world. I mean the land, sea and biomes. But bare land is not good looking at all. I want to randomly add some trees, grasses and buildings to it, just to make it look better. But before we start, I want to make some clear requirements. Firstly, the plants should only be grown on the land. I don't want to see a tree or a flower floating on the sea. That's weird. Secondly, the distribution of the decorations should be even. We need to avoid two cities too close to each other. Thirdly, they should look natural. There should be no patterns in their position. Next, the position of this decoration should also be logical, just like the real world. Pine trees can only be found in the cold area and there is no grass in the desert. And the last one, the density of plants should be different depending on the biome. There should be more plants in the rainforest than the tundra. Okay, all I need is to find a way to do that. Easy task. Hey Google, find me a solution to do all the above.
Let me try. Sorry, I guess I can't.
The first way of generating randomness is called pure random. The implementation is simple. Just randomly pick value for position X and Y, and put a tree there. This approach is the easiest, but we could hardly get a decent result. There will always be some trees too close to each other, while some of the spaces are not used at all. I'm not going to use this method. To avoid the closely spawned plants, the second method is to generate a grid and place them right at the center of each cell. Perfect! There will never be trees too close to another. But this looks too precise. They look unnatural. To make it a bit better, we can add some randomness. Say, I pick a dot, randomly find a direction, and move it by a little bit. Well, it's easy and we could get a good result. However, since the direction is randomly picked, two trees could still be too close if they walk towards each other. Sadly, there is no way we could avoid that. Just like, well, we cannot ban pineapple from a pizza either. To get high quality randomness, there is a really complex algorithm called Poisson Disc Sampling. In this method, we pick a tree that is already there and randomly pick another point that is close to but not that close to it. We want it to be close enough so we could utilize the space to the max. We don't want it to be that close, so no trees will stick to each other. If we could find a place as described, we grow a new plant there. Repeat the step until all the spaces are occupied. Cool. We now have our high quality randomness. But wait, how could we adjust the density with Poisson Disc? How could we reduce the number of plants in the cold area? Well, there's another keyword called sample elimination. We could define a distance for each biome. Say, 10 pixels for the rainforest, 15 pixels for the grassland, and, well, 200 pixels for the ice-cold tundra. Then, we calculate the plants that are within the distance of each plant, and find the one with the most plants within the given distance, and terminate it. Repeat the step until we are happy. Here is a basic demo of what the elimination could do. Just start with some samples, and gradually, and well, we have our Lena here, see? Okay, we have eventually gotten the dreaming method of randomness. Now let's do something for the plants. To start it, we do a sample all around the world. Then we remove the samples from the sea, because plants could only survive on land. And we do the sample elimination to reduce the plants for each biome. Repeat the elimination until we are happy. Well, it sounds to be simple, but actually not. There is a question here. When should I stop? Assume we have 100,000 plants all over the world. When is the best time to stop? 90,000? 80,000? Or 50,000? Well, after some tests and wasting a whole afternoon, I decide to pick these as the final result. Actually, I'm still not happy with it, but you know, sometimes you have to let it go. There's another issue here. I have to adjust the distance value for each biome carefully. There's no rule or principle here. I have to try and test and back and forth. I cannot remember how much time I wasted on it. Well, that's one of the pains of making a game, I believe. Okay, we have our plans. The next task is to generate cities. City generation is quite similar to plant generation, with only one major difference. Again, Princess of Seas is a sea seeding game, just like in the Uncharted Waters series. Players will spend all their time on the sea. It means we don't need to waste time in the cities aside from the coastal. Okay, so we generate another Poisson Disc data. This time, we remove the points on the sea and the samples that are too away from the sea. We do another sample elimination with a new distance value for each biome. Cool, cities are evenly distributed all the world. Couldn't be better. I think that's enough for today. Please press like and do subscribe if you like my game. I will post my thoughts and progress during the development. The link to the game is in the description. See you next time.